Welcome to the 33rd American Band College 26th anniversary concert. We did it. We're here, and we're so excited that you at home are watching as we live stream this on YouTube. We have almost 180 students from 35 states and 3 foreign countries with us tonight and this week, in the next couple weeks. These students not only have prepared the music for tonight in the last week, but they've also have done numerous clinics with master teachers from major universities throughout the United States. So we're gonna move right on to the concert, and I'd like to introduce our MC for the night, Tracy Wright.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Seattle Hilton Convention Center. And we would like to say a special hello to all of our family members, friends, and alumni of the American Band College that are joining us this evening via live stream. Richard Saucedo is one of the most prolific composers and arrangers of band music in America today. His high school band at Carmel, Indiana, won the Bands of America Grand Championships in 2005 and 2012. In that same year of 2005, his Carmel High School band performed at the prestigious Midwest Band and Orchestra Clinic. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the podium tonight's first conductor, Richard Saucedo.
Thank you.
After serving as a public school band director in the state of Georgia for 12 years, Jay Gephart was named the director of bands at Purdue University in 1995. Jay serves as the director of the world-famous Purdue University All-American Marching Band and the Purdue University Wind Ensemble. He also serves as the current president of the American Bandmasters Association. Please join me in welcoming our next conductor to the podium, Jay Gephart.
Thank you. In the fall of 1956, the U.S. Supreme Court ordered Clinton High School in Tennessee to desegregate with all deliberate speed, was the way that they worded it in the Supreme Court ruling. So as that happened, there were 12 black students that came to Clinton High School for the first time to start that process. And they would come from an area called Foley Hill and walk down this road to Clinton High School. And they were met by numerous protesters who would throw all kinds of things at them. Really rough trip every morning to the school. But there was one group that was there to greet those 12 students when they got there on the first day. That was the Clinton High School Band. It says a lot about the band community. And regardless of what's going on, today, the band community has always had it figured out. They've always had it figured out. And that's why we don't worry about who's sitting next to us or behind us or whatever. We're a team. And that's what this piece celebrates. Those 12 students and our band fraternity and sorority. This is called Walking Into History.
Thank you.
Robert Ponto is the associate conducting teacher at the University of Oregon, where he also served as the director of bands. We want to recognize Bob here at the American Band College, as this is his 18th consecutive appearance at ABC. Bending genres and electrifying audiences from small towns to major concert halls. The Moanin Frogs offer a fresh approach to chamber music, featuring six saxophones from soprano to bass. The Moanin Frogs give this unique approach to the landscape of chamber music today. Would you please join me in welcoming the Moanin Frogs and their conductor, Robert Ponto.
Eighteen years? It just goes to show some people don't learn. Just a quick word on the title here. It sounds a bit like it's a pest control product. And in fact, what this is, back in kind of the heyday of cartoon animation, 30s, 40s, early 50s, the Warner Brothers had it all figured out with producers like Tex Avery, Chuck Jones, all that. And all that great music by this fellow who people never know his name, Carl Stalling. All that crazy, insane, Bugs Bunny, Looney Tunes stuff. Those guys that worked on the Warner Brothers lot were all stuck in this old, decrepit building that we're quite sure was not up to code in any way. And they dubbed it Termite Terrace. So that's where that title comes from. And this is kind of the composer's salute to that heyday of cartoon animation and music. So we're gonna just take a quick tuning note and then invite our friends to join us.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, those viewing on the YouTube channel, we are going to take a 15-minute intermission. During this time, those viewing via live stream around the world, please consider touching the drop-down tab and consider making a donation to the American Band College. The link is provided for you on the YouTube channel. Would you please also join me in thanking and giving endearing thanks to the founders of the American Band College, Max and Mel McKee. Thank you. We will return in 15 minutes. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the second portion of this evening's American Band College here at the beautiful Hilton Seattle Convention Center. We would like to say a special thank you to Central Washington University and a special endearing thanks for the sponsorship of the wonderful Conn-Selmer Corporation from Elkhart, Indiana, for sponsoring several of our conductors this evening, as well as the Moanin Frogs. Thank you, Conn-Selmer. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming back to the stage the Moanin Frogs. Thank you.
it's been really fun to play for all of you today, to play for you throughout the week, and to experience ABC. The first three pieces that we played today were Wedding Dance by Jacques Press, Leonard Bernstein's Slava, and the Irish traditional Danny Boy. Before we finish with our last song, I wanted to give some thank yous. Of course, thank you to ABC for having us. Thank you to Con Selmer for supporting this event and supporting us. And thank you to all of you for playing music with us and for performing live music for the first time in months and months and months. It's been so incredible. So this next song is an oldie. At least it's an oldie where I come from. Blues and Beat. Watch me for the changes. Try to keep up.
The Moanin Frogs. Now please welcome back to the podium, Jay Gephart from Purdue University. Thank you.
Our next selection is entitled Wolves in Moonlight. Julie Giroux wrote this piece in honor of my dear friend Gladys Wright and the 50th anniversary of the Women Band Directors International. Composition was premiered at the Midwest Clinic 2 years ago, and the focus of this particular piece is Gladys Wright's love of nature and of animals. There's this particular spot in West Lafayette, Indiana called Wolf Park, and Gladys and Al Wright through the years have supported Wolf Park both financially and just being advocates for what they do. And so Julie wrote this piece combining Gladys's love for Wolf Park and also to honor the WBDI. One of the motives that you're gonna hear in this composition is an octave leap throughout, which tries to signify the howling of the wolves at Wolf Park. If you ever have the opportunity to be in West Lafayette, Indiana on a Friday night in the summer, you can sit in the bleachers at Wolf Park and hear the wolves howling in the distance. This is Julie Giroux's Wolves in Moonlight.
Thank you.
please join me in welcoming back to the podium composer and conductor Richard Saucedo.
It has been an absolute honor to, first of all, share the podium with Jay and Robert, two amazing colleagues who I've learned so much from this week. I want to thank all the ABC people, especially Max, Scott McKee, for the invite and letting me be a part of this amazing thing. You know, one of the things that I love to do more than anything is to learn. You know, even at my ripe old age, careful. Okay, even at my age, I still love to learn. And if you love to learn, there's no better place to be than right here at American Band College, because this is where you learn. Right here. So thanks also to the wonderful master's candidates I've had a chance to work with this week. It's just been amazing. The pleasure has been totally mine. These folks are so great and on their way to becoming master teachers. They're already wonderful at what they do, and I can't wait to see what they become. So thanks to all of them. The thing that I've learned the most from them is that we are back. We're back. Okay, we're gonna have some fun here with one of my favorite marches of all time. It's a war horse of the band literature. It's called His Honor March, and we really hope you enjoy it. Thanks so much to all the folks at ABC and all of you.
Can I just take a moment too and reiterate what Richard just said about American Band College? You know, to me, American Band College is more than a place to learn. This is a family. And I have been invited to be part of this family over the years, and I'm so grateful, thanks to Max and to Scott and the entire staff for American Band College. And one of the greatest joys of my year is to follow all the ABC graduates on social media as they share their stories back and forth. And to see them grow in their careers has just been an incredible journey. And so I wish them all well. There's no better place, in my opinion, for students to come and learn and get a master's degree and take that knowledge back to their school programs and make huge differences for their students. About 2 weeks ago, I had the privilege of conducting my park band in Kokomo, Indiana, and there were hundreds of people who showed up at that concert. It It was the first concert we had given in almost 2 years. And so it's not just the directors and the students who are really chomping at the bit to get back to work. Everybody wants to enjoy live music. And so we're excited about that. I'm going to close my portion of the concert with Alfred Reed's Gallop.
ABC students, would you join me in thanking the amazing staff here at the Seattle Hilton Convention Center for all of their glorious efforts. To invite you to be back here with us in this beautiful Emerald Ballroom on July the 4th for our spectacular concert at 7:30 p.m. featuring several guest conductors as well as the legendary Boston Brass. So we would ask that you would join us again on July the 4th for this special Independence Day concert here at the Seattle Hilton Convention Center. We have our guest coming back out in just a moment. We'll be joined again by Dr. Robert Ponto and the Moanin Frogs. So if you'll give us just a moment to get a few things set up, We also would like to take this opportunity to thank those who have already made generous donations to the American Band College on our YouTube channel. If you haven't had the opportunity to do that at this time, just touch the arrow there on the right-hand portion of your screen and scroll down, and we appreciate all of your efforts. We'll be back in just a moment. We would like to thank Brian Peter Productions for that. You have a future. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back to the podium Dr. Robert Ponto and the Moanin Frogs. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, our final number for the evening, featuring a surprise guest. These band directors that are sitting all around you, even some of the Moanin Frogs, probably started beginning band when they rented their instrument for that very first night. They got their band book on day one, and there was a name, Tim Lautzenheiser. And that name has been with us even here at ABC. Is continuing to teach us from day one beginning band and here as band directors. Would you please enjoy the combined bands of RO and YG and the Moanin Frogs with the one and only Dr. Tim Lautzenheiser.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Saucedo, Bob Ponto, Dr. Tim Lautzenheiser, and the Moanin Frogs. The 179 students of the American Band College. Thank you and good night.
All right.